I'm Mike from Mocolab. This is our Phantom Veo 4K. It's available through rental with an op from us, with or without our Bolt, but it's also available for rental directly to DPs and camera operators through Expressway Cinema Rentals. It gives you the features of the Phantom Flex, the 4K 1000 frames on a Super 35 sensor, but the Phantom Veo 4K has that same sensor, but in a more compact body that you can take out in the field, shoulder mounted, on a dolly, on a gimbal, or with us on a Bolt. The Phantom workflow may seem intimidating, especially if you've only ever used an older model or the Phantom Flex 4K. But I'm here today with a couple tips and tricks for those who are taking the Phantom out on their own. So if you're not familiar with the Phantom workflow, you have to forget about rolling and cutting. Instead of continuously recording to a card, it buffers to RAM, and then you have to choose what you want to keep. You can set a point at the beginning, the end, in relation to the frames of when you press the trigger button. For example, if you set at the beginning of a clip and you have a 2 second partition on your RAM, press the button, 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, you've recorded forward. If you set your trigger at the end, it would look back 2 seconds, which effectively would be your cut time. Once you selected the trigger point, you can trigger it in a couple of ways. You can press the trigger button on the back of the camera, or you can use the handy dandy pickle switch in port 1 trigger port. There's 2 ways to store a file once it's in the RAM. You can put it on a CF card, which is the most portable option, or you can run it on a 10 gig Ethernet connection tethered directly to a computer for the fastest option. The Phantom Veo records a Cine RAW file. It's a RAW proprietary format. It gives you 3 options for gamma curve, Rec 709, log 1, which is 1600 ISO, and log 2, which is 2500. If you find yourself in need of higher frame rates than 938 at its full resolution, or greater than 1000 at UHD, if you needed to get to 1200 or 1500 frames, you can steal from your vertical resolution and up your frame rate. Auto BREF does a current session reference, aka Blackshade, aka APR, whatever you want to call it. Every time you go to enter capture mode, it will run that automatically for you. You can't forget to black reference when you keep auto black reference on. We're really excited to have this tool, the Phantom Veo 4K, available for rent. It's really helped up level our work here at Mocolab, and we can't wait to see what you do with it too.